In April 2015, a certain phone call led to a discovery. After the Third Battle of Seoul ended, one man recalled a battle that took place in Mungyeong, Gyeongsangbuk-do. To confirm that such a battle actually took place, the documentary crew met with Major General Son Jang-lae, who was deployed to Mungyeong.
Battalion, 여기가야.
이 마크가
그래, 이거야.
여기 가운데 동그란
태그 마크지.
According to Major General Son, he was part of a special strike force attached to a U.S. squad stationed in Mungyeong, in which he engaged the enemy in a fierce battle. In January 1951, the Third Battle of Seoul took place when China entered the Korean War and forced UN forces to retreat. UN forces held the enemy back near the center of Korean Peninsula. Mungyeong was located safely behind this defense line. But what happened in Mungyeong on one fateful day? After the Third Battle of Seoul, many war refugees fled to Busan. In the long march to Busan, displaced civilians could not find shelter in the downtown, so they eventually settled in Uamdong. This cowshed was used as a shelter for several families fleeing the war, using thin boards to cover the gaps in the walls. In the Japanese colonial period, Uamdong was once used by Japanese to quarantine cows from Busan and Gyeongnam before sending them to Japan. A person can barely pass through this narrow alley, which was built by refugees during the war. It was a constant struggle to survive at the time, and there are traces of how the refugees lived in Uamdong. This cold noodle shop opened during the Korean War and is still open. The original shop owner lived in Hamgyeongdo, in the north, but was able to gain passage to Busan during the Hungnam retreat. She used to own a cold noodle shop in Hungnam and opened a new shop here once she arrived. The current owner is the third generation in the family to run the shop. This will was left by the owner's father before he passed away.
일대가 2006년도 돌아가시기 직전에 제가 우리가 그뭐 통일이 되면 고향에 찾아가라고 본적하고 약도 하고 또 유수입니다 이 그림이.
His father sent letters to his grandfather in North Korea, but never heard back from him.
이제 우리 애가집 쪽에는 여기 바다입니다. 이 흥남시예요. 한경남도 흥남시 시 전체입니다 이게. 우리 이거 본적이 한경남도 흥남시 수설이고 수설이 73번지 우리 아버지 고향이고 또 엄마는 한경남도 흥남시 내홀이 저 그거 저 내홀하면 일사고 때 배 타고 난 그 바다, 그 이 앞에 그 바닷가가 내려오거든요.
In late December of 1950, the Korean War was not going well for the UN forces. Chinese forces had unexpectedly entered the Korean War, dealing major casualties to UN forces. UN forces decided to carry out a major evacuation by ship at Hungnam Port. The problem was the war refugees. 300,000 displaced civilians had gathered at Hungnam Port. When the refugees were evacuated, the last sight they recall of their hometown was a loud explosion and black smoke. The refugees were taken to Busan. Busan had a population of 400,000 people before the war, but quickly swelled to 2 million as refugees kept streaming in. Due to the crowded situation, refugees erected tents in the streets and on the beaches. Tombstone Village in Busan was formed during the influx of these refugees. There are telling signs around the village that explain how it got its name. The alleys are still narrow to this day. What is this tombstone doing in this alley?
이게 그냥 일본 정치 때 여기 일본들 일본 묘지라 이쪽으로 공동 묘지인데 이제 6.25 때 피란 나와가지고 시청 앞에 있으니까 이제 천막을 가지고 와서 여기서 해고 살아라.
Korean War refugees collected tombstones to build houses on top of the cemetery. This place became Tombstone Village. After the victory at the Battle of Incheon, UN forces gained the upper hand and marched past the 30th parallel, all the way to Amnok River. However, on November 2nd, Chinese forces invaded Korea and changed the momentum of the war. Chinese forces hid during the day and marched at night. Due to the sheer number of Chinese soldiers, UN forces were hard-pressed despite their superior firepower. So they were forced to retreat. Seoul fell back into enemy hands. The battle front lines were redrawn and moved south of the 38th parallel. UN forces regrouped and focused on defending Daegu.
당시 우리 그 한반도를 놓고 봤을 때에 그 병참 보급선은 두 가지 길밖에 없었어요. 하나는 대구를 부산에서 대구와 대전을 연결해서 서울로 올라오는 그런 이제 그 철도 내지는 국도가 이제 있었고 하나는 대구에서 영주로 해서 온주로 이제 그 올라오는 중앙선이 있었어요. 그래서 이게 두 개가 유엔 병참선의 대동맥이라 할 수 있는데 만약에 적이 그 대구를 점령해서 이 지역을 확보한다면은 일단 우리 대한민국 국민과 정치 지도자 입장에서는 거의 패닉 상태에 올 수 있는
The Rhee government moved to Busan, which became the temporary capital. During the 3 years of war, all major decisions were made in this building. The building was originally used by the provincial governor and then retrofitted to be used as a central government office and the president's residence. Today, this historic building stands as it did during the Korean War. The reception hall was used for appointment ceremonies and handling foreign relations. Presidential briefings also took place here. An office adjacent to the reception hall was used by President Syngman Rhee, who presided over the war. Ebb and Flow is a book published in America that recounts details of the Korean War. According to the book, in the aftermath of the Third Battle of Seoul, the Ri government had to make a difficult decision on whether to evacuate to Japan if UN forces fell back to the middle section between Seoul and Busan. Was this a historical fact? The documentary crew visited the Institute for Military History that holds archives of the Korean War. Many top secret documents are also kept here.
네, 여기는 지금 6.25 전쟁과 관련된 1차 사료들.
1차 사료들.
1차 사료들만 모아놓은 곳입니다. 전부 다 원본이고요.
One declassified document has the words top secret stamped on it. The document outlines a plan in the event the Russians entered the Korean War, which would then likely escalate into a global war. In the worst-case scenario, where the Korean Peninsula were to fall into enemy hands, ROK forces would be deployed to the Philippines and Indochina as a line of defense, while the Ri government would be evacuated to Jeju Island and collaborate with Chiang Kai-shek in defending Asia. It shows that UN forces were experiencing heavy setbacks in the war.
이제 한국 정부가 일본으로 철수하고 나면 이 한국군은 어떻게 운영할 것인가 여기에 대한 얘기도 나와요. 이제 여기서 뭐라고 그러냐면 필리핀이나 대만을 방어하는데 한국군을 운영을 하는 것이 어떻겠느냐라는 얘기가 나오는데 그것은 사실은 이제 중국군이 참전하면서 미군이 이것이 세계 전쟁으로 비화할 거라는 굉장히 위기감을 가졌다는 그런 뜻이 되는 거죠.
The invasion of Chinese forces caught UN forces by surprise, pushed south. ROK and UN forces were outnumbered by an endless wave of Chinese soldiers. The war seemed to be heading into a protracted conflict. The prospect of losing the war was real. The US seriously considered withdrawing US troops from Korea. However,
리치웨이 장군의 회신의 핵심은 한반도에서 미군이 철수하는 것은 있을 수 없는 일이다. 어차피 한반도를 우리가 끝까지 지켜야 되고 어떠한 희생을 치르더라도 여기를 지켜야 된다. 일본으로 철수하거나 아니면 제주도를 기점으로 해서 다시 저항한다는 것은 사실은 군사적으로 의미가 없다는
General Matthew Ridgway coordinated a defensive boundary called Line D. But holding off the enemy on the ground was much harder. So Line D had to be moved south to Samtok. In the book Ebb and Flow, Line D had a buffer of 60 miles. That would enable a hasty retreat if the enemy advanced deeper. To secure the Line D boundary, the British sent troops to Chungju to counter guerrilla tactics, while the 7th Infantry Division carried out patrols in Tanyang, Chungju, and Mungyeong. A new division was formed to defend the boundary. It was an ROK reconnaissance unit that would engage in anti-guerrilla warfare. ROK recon soldiers were actually very effective during the war. More than anything else, they knew the terrain well and developed crucial relations with civilians in gaining tactical information. General Ridgway even sent out a memo to US soldiers that ordered them to not be spotted by ROK recon soldiers. This was to prevent friendly fire.
그러니까 이제 당시 특수 상황에서는 소위 말하면 이제 그런 부대뿐만 아니고 태스크포스를 또 구성해서 특수임무 부대라고 해가지고 때로는 순수하게 미군으로만 편전될 수도 있었고 때로는 거기에 우리 국군이 또 포함된 그런 이제 특수부대가 편성이 돼가지고 그런 작전을 6.25 전쟁 3년 기간 동안에 수없이 수행을 했어요.
General Edward Almond, who was the commander of the 10th Corps, formed a special unit that he deployed to Andong, Yeongju, and Chungju. The 10th Corps organized a special forces unit comprised of ROK soldiers. It was called Special Activities Group, or SAG. Major General Son Jang-lae of the reserves was a member of SAG. He was an SAG commander who fought in the Mungyeong battle. But how was his unit created?
육군 본부에서 아마 미
8군이라든지 영군사령부라든지 뭐 역수관 이런 걸 통해서 이런 대대를 하나 우리한테 보내달라 이렇게 됐겠지. 그래서 그 대대가 편성이 된 거죠.
예.
편성이 됐는데 그런데 있던 게 아니라 그런 대대 편성해서 온 거야. 편성. 그러니까 편성하는 부대에 내가 중대장으로 가게 되는 거죠. 편성. 그러니까 그 사람들 전부 다른 부대에 있던 사람들이 왔는데 대부분이 전상자들이 많았어. 대부분이.
Members of SAG received special training on a secret training camp in Japan. They were given weapons training and took parachuting exercises to prepare them for landing operations. The training was grueling and casualties occurred like actual combat.
We are just 10명이 바로 고무보트에 올라탄다고. 그래가지고 노를 저어서 가는데 그냥 파도가 치니까요. 그 훈련 도중에 이 캡사이즈라고 그래, 캡사이즈 전복대. 전복되면요. 그때부터 수영해서 나와야 하잖아. 어, 바람 불지. 배는 배대로 저쪽 갔지. 난 배를 잡아야지. 그러니까요. 무겁지. 뭐 전투 섰지. 뭐 이 탄약했지. 했으니까요. 결국은 다 버리게 돼. 총이 그만큼 돼. 권총 다 버려야 돼. 뭐 도저히 수영도 못 하겠는데 총이 어딨어. 총 다 버리고. 그래가지고 그때는 잠깐 이거 몇 대가 가니까. 그 탁을 보지 않으니까 아 저기 간다 그 배가 오거든. 그 오는데 오는 동안에 있어야 하는데 오는 동안에 빠져 죽는 사람도 있고 와도 뭐 파도가 치니까 가는 저리 흘러가는 것도 야간이니까 보이지도 않고.
The hellish training went on for 3 months. After the ROK soldiers received training necessary for carrying out special missions, they were assigned to a front division and participated in special operations.
그 사람들은 그랬어. 대부대가 가려니까요. 이렇게 가잖아. 이렇게 가면 돼. 대부대가 가기 전에 반드시 수색부대가 가야 하잖아요. 그래서 저기 있냐 없냐 그걸 봐야 한단 말이에요. 그러니까 수색부대라는 것이 영어 해가지고는 그 주민들한테 물어봐도 말도 안 통하잖아요. 그러니까 우리 제일 앞에 군단의 최앞에다가 우리 한국군 부대를 준 거예요. 대대를.
Scouting units were sent ahead of an advancing battalion to detect danger. The outcome of battles heavily depended on their competence in carrying out recon missions. The first mission given to SAG was a recon task on Mount Shinbul of Gyeongsangnam-do. This area was part of the Mount Taebaek range and had many high peaks with elevations exceeding 1,000 meters. Due to the tough terrain, North Korean partisans hid in these mountains. SAG engaged the enemy for the first time in this area.
그때만 해도 시물산에 적이 많고 막 하는데 우리가 제대로 훈련도 제대로 안 됐고 또 부대가 조직돼가지고 별로 이런 제대로 훈련 제대로 못 받고 했기 때문에 전투 성적이 별로 좋지 않았어. 막 아주 실전을 했지다. 하고 그때 중대장도 죽어요. 윤웅모라는 사람이 내 옆에서 바로 중대고 난 소대장인데 했는데 그 사람이 죽어. 총에 맞아 죽어. 그러니까 상대 우리의 피해도 컸어요. 그러니까 우리 부대 자체에 대해서 그 미 식군단에서도 별로 평가를 높게는 안 했지. 아, 이 부대가 별로 전투를 못하는구나 이렇게 됐지.
After failing their first mission, the unit headed to Mungyeong. Mungyeong is a gateway that connects Yeongnam to Seoul. If Mungyeong fell into enemy hands, Daegu and Busan would be vulnerable. UN forces sent many troops to Mungyeong to hold Line D. The special recon unit was also deployed to Mungyeong. 'Situated in the county center is the local precinct. It was once a marketplace where merchants from Seoul and Yeongnam came to trade and barter goods.
안동에서 예천, 수평, 요 문경 그걸 걸쳐가지고 충주로 가는 게 제일 길은 길이에요. 서울 가는 제일 길은 길이에요. 영남에 제일 빠른 길이에요.
On the day the documentary crew arrived in Dongno County, there was a village incident. An old Korean War era shell was found behind the precinct.
이 돌 이제 팀이를 네. 이제 준비를 하려고 올 포크레이 디리가에 작업하다가 포가 이런 게 나왔어요.
A nearby ammunition depot collected the old mortar shell. What type of artillery shell was discovered?
수거한 탄약을 보관하는 거죠.
아, 요번에 문경 지구에서 예. 여기 수거해온 6.25 때 예. 81mm 박격포에서 사용한 탄약이 되겠습니다.
It is believed that the shell was used against North Korean partisans by UN forces during the Korean War. Before the Korean War broke out, there were frequent battles occurring in Mungyeong due to North Korean partisans who were hiding in the mountains. The villagers organized their own armed unit to round up the North Korean partisans. Then, the Korean War broke out. North Korean partisans carried out attacks in the Mount Taebaek Range, Mount Chiri, Miryang, Cheongdo, and other places in Gyeongsangbuk. UN forces even assigned a division to counter the North Korean partisans who were stirring up fear and confusion in villages. Among the 80,000 North Korean prisoners of war taken, 48,000 of them were North Korean partisans residing in the south. UN forces had to fight North Korean forces in the front lines while also dealing with North Korean partisans in the flanks. In this valley, North Korean partisans massacred a police force before the Korean War occurred. They cut off the telephone line to the village, after which they made a fake call to the precinct. Then the North Korean partisans ambushed the police officers who came.
이 중간에서 전화선을 끊어 가지고 마강 밑에 내려가면요. 경찰 전공비가 따로 있어요. 그 전선을 끊어 가지고 여기 이제 공비가 막 나타나 가지고 난리가 났다. 숙대밭이 됐다 이러니까
15 police officers responded to the call and were killed in a surprise attack. A monument that commemorates the slain police officers stands near the valley. Before the Korean War had started, Mungyeong had tense relations between leftists and rightists. The Special Activities Group arrived here on January 12, 1951, and camped at an elementary school in Dongno County. The county already had countermeasures in place to defend themselves from armed North Korean partisans. This stone church was built from stones taken from the fortress wall built around the village. ROK forces used the fortress wall as cover to reach Dongno County. In a video footage taken by a war correspondent, the fortress wall they built is clearly visible. The villagers worked together to build it.
이제 휴전이 되고 예. 이제 필요 없으니까 이렇게 됐는데 예. 근데 이게 그 당시 이제 공비가 동네별로 다 있고 막 뭐 난리가 났거든 그 당시에.
In addition to building a wall, the villagers also built trenches.
여기에 노폭이 한 5m?
5m.
5m 거리를 저 아래서부터 저 아래 이제 밭머리 식량 꽂아서부터 일로 해 돌아서 이 밭으로 해 가지고 저 아래 넘겨지기까지 돌려팠어.
The stone fortress wall and trenches protected the village and precinct. Sixty years after the Korean War, Major General Son returns to Mungyeong. He recalls how the village looked long ago.
단양 가는 길 길목이고 여기서 조그만
아 여기도 조금 그때 보던 것이 바로 이거라고 예. 돌담 있다고 그랬잖아
예. 그래서 그 조그만 요만했었나 보죠
그러네요
요만하고 있지. 뒤로 이렇게 공간이 조금 있고
Son was in a unit that had 300 men. His unit was split into three companies, and he commanded the lead unit. The Major General scouted the area around the fortress wall before the rest of the troops arrived in Dongno Elementary hours later. All that has changed at the school is the location of the trees. Most of the men in the unit were exhausted after a long march from Busan without resting. Morale was also low due to heavy casualties suffered in the Battle of Mount Shinbu. The battalion commander suggested that the troops rest on the school grounds, but Son voiced his concerns. So the troops dug a trench on higher ground near the school and spent the night outdoors. The weary soldiers had to brave minus 20 degrees Celsius temperatures while camping out in the trenches. The trenches they dug is now part of Cheoksongni. At the time, the special recon unit was digging trenches. North Korean forces had already taken position, just 300 meters away from the freshly dug trenches. The ROK forces were unaware that the enemy was nearby. This is Cheoksongni, the very place where North Korean forces had a base of operation. The village elders still clearly remember how everything unfolded.
집집이 나와 있었죠.
집집이다.
그리고 우리 집이 여기 본부라.
그래서 이렇게 되면 180도죠.
According to Mr. Hwang Tae-young, about 3,000 North Korean soldiers swarmed the village, and their commander used his house as his headquarters.
아니, 자기네가 승리한다 그러. 뭐 이 3일 내에 우리가 이제 김천까지 낙동강까지 내려갈 수 있다.
North Korean forces and ROK forces were just 300 meters away from each other. However, the ROK were still oblivious of the enemy in their midst. The reason for this was that Mungyeong was supposedly safely behind the defensive boundary that ran through Pyeongtaek, Wonju, and Samcheok. Then how did 3,000 North Korean soldiers slip through undetected?
우리가 이제 일사후퇴 이후에 평택하고 이제 원주 삼척선 그 선에서 이제 우리가 이제 그 방어선을 이제 형성하실 때 그 중부 전선에서 쇄를 직결했던 북한군 2군단이 그 당시 이제 제천과 그 정선에 그 한 24km 정도의 그 공백이 있었는데 우리 국군 3군단하고 미 이제 10군단 그 사이에 그 지역의 그 빈 공백을 이용해서 그쪽으로 이제 그 남진에서 침투해 들어온 거죠.
According to VN Razuvayev, a Soviet military advisor, North Korea's Second Corps carried out meticulous planning to reach Mungyeong. After the Battle of Incheon, UN forces made rapid progress in marching northward, pushing North Korean forces beyond the 38th parallel. UN troops used existing roads to make progress. Upon reclaiming the territory around the 38th parallel, UN forces mounted a full assault to successfully take Wonsan Port and Pyongyang. They continued to move forward. Instead of retreating, one North Korean division remained behind. They were ordered to engage in guerrilla warfare. Who were these North Korean soldiers? Records show that they were the 10th Division, attached to the 2nd Corps. Their commander was Major General Lee Bang-nam.
북한군 14단은 1950년 3월에서 6월 사이에 조직된 부대였는데요. 우리로 말하자면 예비군을 모아서 만든 부대입니다. 그렇다고 해서 약한 부대는 아니고 1947년부터 계속 전 국민들을 훈련을 시켜 인민들을 훈련을 시켰거든요, 북한이. 그러니까 정예사단, 완편사단으로 창설된 사단이고요. 북한군 제14단은. 그리고 그 당시 소련제 중공체 최신 무기 다 준.
How was this division able to penetrate deep into the south without being detected? They mostly kept to the mountain trails. One of these trails was frequently used by villagers in the area.
폭은 대충 이 정도.
폭은 요거보다 더 적지요. 1m도 채 안 됐습니다. 폭은 1m도 안 됐고 여기 우측 도로가 생김으로 말미암아 이 도로가 폐쇄됐는데 이것이 전형적인 주민들이 생활하던 일상생활에 사용하던 소로길입니다. 여기서부터 우리 소재지까지는 약 한 1.5km 내지 2km. 예. 그런데 요 일로 통해서 이제 이민군들이 침입하게 됩니다.
3,000 North Korean soldiers used these narrow paths to reach Chuksongni in Dongno County.
It's cold in the evening. In the evening, it's cold. The children are made of trees. So, for the heat, they put the fire on the fire. I don't know. 저게 어디서 볼지 모르니까 내가 막 가가지고 밖에로 이제 남을 다 차버려 당장 끄라고 말이지. 그러니까 상대방은 인민군 우리가 오고 또 불 켠 거 다 본 거지. 그리고 내가 막 그 어떤 장에 와서 발로 막 차가면서 불 막 끄는 거 다 보고 있은 거지. 우리 그때 몰랐지.
On the day of the battle, most of the ROK forces were asleep at dawn. Then the surprise attack was unleashed. Among the three companies, Major General Son's unit was situated in the middle, taking the brunt of the assault. The first attack was directed at the north side of Gyeongsangbuk-do. The local police and armed youth members joined the ROK forces.
올라가다가 이 논머리에다 조만한 야포를 하나 가져와가지고 그때 장치를 시긴 한데 포 한 발도 못 쏴봤어. 이런 지금 포가리고 멀어야 되는데 직사포기에 예. 곡사포도 아니고 쏠라 쏠 수 없고 뭐 바짝만 대미서 달라붙었는데 어디다 총질을 해요. 포 쏘가지고 못했지.
3,000 enemy soldiers against 300 ROK soldiers who were spread across three units. They were outnumbered 10 to 1. The commanders seriously debated retreating. Since they had no reinforcements, all three units were in danger of being annihilated. But retreating was also a dangerous option because they were surrounded. The officers finally agreed to continue fighting. Around 6 a.m., the enemy mounted a second wave of attacks. It came from the north side again. The enemy broke through Major General Son's unit defenses, but a decisive victory eluded the North Korean forces due to Son's battle directives.
호수에서 나오지 말라. 호수에서 나오고 움직이면은 전이 맞서 죽는다. 그러니까 절대 호수에서 나오지 말라. 호 바깥에서 움직이면 이게 전부 적이라고 생각하고 쏴 죽이라. 그다음에 포졌으니까 우리가 갖고 있는 탄약이 전부 안 봐야 뭐 250발 정도밖에 안 됐어. 나중에 제복을 받기 전에는 250발만 가지고 있어.
그걸로 버텨야 돼.
어, 탄약은 이거니까 최후의 한 발이 네 생명을 살리느냐, 네가 거기 맞아주느냐는 그게 결정되는 거야. 그러니까 절대 총 쏘지 마. 내가 쏘라 할 때만 쏴.
Moments later, the enemy started their third attack. This time it came from the west side, where the ROK forces had a tactical advantage. The North Korean forces quickly withdrew. Then a fourth assault commenced from all sides. The North Koreans went all out in their attack.
Here, 이제 마찰 하는 마이크 아니라서 그때 높았지. 그래 이제 여기서 돌격 개시 이러면 이쪽으로도 내려가고
이쪽으로.
마을로도 내려가고 돌격 개시 이러면 막 이래가지고 막 김을 저먹거든요.
The North Korean forces used all of their firepower, but their mortar attacks did not result in heavy casualties. Many of the shells were duds and did not detonate. In the heat of the battle, ROK forces tried to retreat to the school, but they came under fire from all sides and had to fall back. They were forced to continue fighting.
이제 그 야단을 쳤는데 여기서 이제 학교를 후퇴하니 이런 짐이 적은 데서 또 몰리 들어오네. 그러니까 요 놈은 또 우리가 후퇴하게 따라 들어올 거 아니야. 따라 들어오고 저거리가 몰리 들어오고 이렇게 환장할 일 아니야. 죽는 거지 이제. 이제 이게 어떻게 해요? 실탄이 모자랄 거 아니야. 그러니까 이제 배동을 그 이제 대위가 한 발씩 준비해놔라. 어차피 작은 애 저 사람들한테 포위를 당해서 죽을 바이면 자살을 하자.
Although they were conserving their ammo, they were running out of bullets fast. Their only hope was for reinforcements to reach them in time. However, the U.S. troops that were on their way had a setback.
이게 호흡다리가 아니고 저 다리가 호흡다리.
저 앞에.
아, 저기 앞에요?
예,
사람 타고, 버스를 타고 안다는 빨간 지등기가 있잖아.
여기가?
호흡다리라는 게 저게 호흡다리 아니에요?
아, 저게 다리가
여기 호흡다리. 지금 다리를 놔야지. 그전에 다리가 없고 돌매 요만큼 한 거 놓고 그거 뒤지고 건네댕겼어. 뻥 터질 경우만 이르고만 삭가다지 해버리는 거야.
One U.S. tank that was coming as part of the reinforcements hit an anti-tank mine. It was overturned. North Korean forces had secretly planted mines around the area to block their retreat. The enemy continued to attack mercilessly. The ROK forces were completely isolated. But then, a miracle happened.
무전기를 암만 사용을 해도 교신이 안 됩니다. 그래 실탄도 다 떨어지지 배도 고프지 환장할 때가 아니라 뭐 그날에 누가 밥 해줄 사람이 어디 있어? 그 위에다 보니까 대구 동천 비행장으로 이 연락이 돼서 무전기 됐어.
After several futile attempts, a radio communication finally got through to UN forces, and an airstrike was called. Helicopters resupplied the ROK forces with ammunition. Despite the ROK counterattack, North Korean forces launched a fifth assault wave. The battle reached a fevered pitch, and civilian casualties began to mount. After five attack waves launched in the span of 2 days, the battle finally ended on the 14th. the 3,000-strong North Korean unit retreated. Numerous bodies of North Korean soldiers were found on the battleground after 2 days of non-stop, intense fighting. It was a miraculous victory. When the North Korean troops retreated, they forced the villagers to carry their wounded.
사람만 내면 총대리 되고 보상병 얻고 가자고.
그 사람들은 자기가 아프면서도 총을 가지고 있어 가지고 나를 안 믿고 가면 쏜다 해 가지고 그분이 내중에 가서 가다 밤에도 가다 보니까 저불고 총도 떨어뜨리고 이래 가지고 시 간다고 놓고 찍기 왔다고 이런 이야기도 있어.
In a command report by the 10th Corps, enemy casualties were estimated to be between 400 to 1,200 killed or wounded, while only 11 ROK soldiers were killed and 35 were wounded. A later survey revealed that actual enemy casualties numbered over 1,200 and 80 POWs were taken.
나는 포를 다 잡았으니까 알았죠.
예.
보니까 뭐 대략 보니까 이게 뭐 한 2, 300명 정도는 다 알았지, 다 봤지. 그러니까 정인들은 3,000명이니까 그 10대 1 아니야. 이까지 그 때리면 무기 다 뺐고 어? 그렇잖아. 우리 무기 다 뺏어가고 큰 전과를 낼 줄 알았지. 근데 우리가 그렇게 그 호석에서 안 나올 줄 그만큼 몰랐지. 다 지금 도망갈 줄 알았지.
After suffering heavy losses, North Korea's 10th Division left Mungyeong and fell back to Andong. However, they were surrounded by the 10th Corps in the north and the 1st Marine Division to the south. Kim Il-sung ordered the 10th Division to wage guerrilla warfare, but further records of their movements have not been found. After the Mungyeong battle, the commanding North Korean officer fell into a depression and failed to give any orders. The outcome of the Mungyeong battle carried ramifications on which side would ultimately win the war.
그러니까 이제 문경이 이제 북한군에게 이제 빼앗겼다면은 북한군은 거기서 멈추지 않고 그들에게 부여했던 임무였던 대구를 이제 점령하게 된다면은 국군과 유엔군의 일단 테러가 이제 차단되고 그다음에 대구는 또 그 남부 지역의 중앙 위치에 있기 때문에 국군과 유엔군이 동서로 이제 분단되는 양단될 수 있는 거기에 이제 또 대구는 바로 그들의 최종 목표인 그 부산을 지척에 두고 있기 때문에 북한군에는 굉장히 유리한 반면에 우리 그 국군하고 유엔에게는 우리가 그 장담할 수 없는 그런 아주 그 불행한 사태로까지 연결될 수 있는 그런 그 상황이었던 거죠.
작전 장교를 했으니까 동시에 여기에요?
예.
아 여기 다 모여 있어?
예.
어 그럼 된 거야.
Major General Son visits the Senior Citizens Association in Dongno County.
뭐 편하신 대로 만나세요.
그래 그래. 동노 노인회.
예. 저번에 말씀드렸었죠. 아이고 머리.
These men remember the battle that took place here.
아이고 참요. 자네가 깊은 의미였습니다.
Decades have passed since they fought together. In the Mungyeong battle, 17 members of the Youth Defense Forces and 8 police officers fought alongside the ROK forces. They are able to share their perspectives of the battle with their old commander.
50m 안에 들어왔을 때
그럼요.
요즘 시체 덩어리였었잖아요.
아, 뭐 매일 전투만 하고 피곤하고 춥고 하니까 그러면 우리 학교에서 오늘은 좀 편안히 자고.
Former youth member Cho Yun-sop, who fought for 2 days in Mungyeong, brings Major General Son to a memorial monument.
그렇죠.
두부를 찾아갔습니다.
아.
This memorial honors the fallen soldiers who sacrificed their lives in the Mungyeong battle. The original memorial was smaller and placed on a village corner, so the war veterans moved it here to let people know about the sacrifices that their comrades made long ago.
여기 뒤에 보면은 여기 기록이 다 돼 있습니다. 여기 있네. 조윤석.
The Battle of Mungyeong was a critical victory that held the front line of the UN forces under impossible odds. Yet, it was forgotten for more than half a century. The valor of these men has been belatedly recognized.
그냥 그거로 그냥 잊혀지고 그냥 그거로 묻어지고 말았겠지. 그냥 워낙 했다는 건데 난 그 자리에서 바로 떠났으니까 전투 끝나고 바로 떠났기 때문에 그런데 미국에서 그걸 알기 때문에 이렇게 큰 전투를 했는데 훈장 안 주느냐 이제 미국이 줬어요.
보면
여기 딱 제 손이랑 나와 있어요.
예, 손이랑 딱
쓰잖아.
Major General Son received a medal from the U.S. for his bravery, but not from South Korea, because his special recon unit was attached to a U.S. squad. After that first fateful battle, Son fought in many other battles, but his victory in Mungyeong remained his most unforgettable one. It is also seared in the memory of Cho Yun-sop, who was only 16 at the time.
사진을 찍는데 모자를 찍으면 되나?
사, 조금만 더 숙여주시겠어요, 앞으로? 자. 하나, 둘, 셋.
Before it is too late, more official war accounts of the Korean War need to be released and studied. Remembering history lays the foundation for not repeating the same mistakes in the future.